Okay, namaste, good afternoon, and welcome to you all here on our radio education program, which is sponsored by Nepal Police School, Gaumra Rautat, with media partner Radio Madhes Masala 106.4 MHz. Okay, it's me here, Santosh Kumar Thakur, with class 4 math. Okay, so as we know, yes. We are in our previous class, yes, we were discussing on this, that addition and subtraction of, yes, like fraction, yes, and that, we have already done and solved some questions relating, related with addition of like fractions, yes. So today we are going to discuss, yes, subtraction. On subtraction of like fractions. So students, I repeat again that, yes, you know all about the like fraction, yes. So first of all, you have to know about the like fraction, yes. That means the fractions, two or more than two fractions having the same denominators are known as, yes, what? Like fraction. Very good. So here, yes, we have a formula or trick, yes, to find the like fraction, yes, that is what? Subtraction of like fraction is. So here, subtraction of like fraction is equal to what? Yes, as you know, yes, in the addition, yes, we add all the numerator, yes, what is over there in the, yes, in the fractions, yes, in the same way here in subtraction also we should, yes, subtract the numerator by the denominators. Yes, because, yes, here also we should subtract the, yes, we should subtract the numerator. Yes, we can write here difference of numerator. Yes, this is the formula that we can use there. Difference of numerator. Yes, and there upon denominator, because, yes, in like fraction, as you know, all the denominators are same, so that we can use any one denominator from them. Yes, so here. Yes, sometimes we have the questions like this. Yes, so let's start the questions. Yes, suppose in first questions we have given the questions like this. Yes, 3 by 6 minus, yes, 2 by 6. For example, yes, we are doing example. Yes, so here, as you know, students, yes, we have here, yes, these two fractions, we have given here two fractions, yes, and they both are like fractions, yes, as you know, because they have the same denominator, yes, 6 and 6, so that the fractions 3 by 6 and 2 by 6, these both are like fractions, yes, so that, yes, we should direct apply this method, yes, difference of numerators. So what are the numerators? 3 and 2, so we should subtract them with each other, 3 minus 2 by, yes, denominator, yes. So what are the denominators? 6 and 6. So we should write 1/6 from them, yes. So here, yes, what is the answer? 3 minus 2 is equal to 1 and by 6. This is the answer, yes. So I hope you are understanding. Yes, don't be confused. Here we have given two fractions, yes, and one of them, one is 3 by 6 and other is 2 by 6. Yes, they both are the like fractions, so that we can apply the same method or formula, difference of numerators by denominators, yes, in the same way, yes, we have the numerator 3 and 2, so that we should subtract them with each other. That means 3 minus 2, and we should direct copy the denominator, because there is only two numerators. Yes, that is what. If the denominators are same, we should copy only one denominator from them. Yes. So here we have written here 6. Yes. So here the difference is what? 3 minus 2 is 1 and upon 6. So this is the answer. Yes. In the same way, let's take other example. Yes. So the other question will be like this. Yes. Don't be confused. Yes. 6 by 8 minus 1 by 8 minus yes, 2 by 8. Yes, friends, look here and listen carefully. Yes. Here. Yes, friends, yes, we have. We have here, yes, what? 6 by 8, 1 by 8, and 2 by 8. Okay, we have three fractions. Yes, and first upon, before subtracting them, yes, first upon, we need to find whether the given fractions are like fractions or not. Yes, so if they are like fractions, then again we can apply the same method or same formulas, yes, to find the difference or to for subtracting. Yes, so here we have the numerator 6, 1, 2, yes, in it. So we can subtract them with each other. That means 6 minus 1 minus 2 by, they both are 3 half, yes, the same denominator. So we should write only 1 from them. Yes, so 8. Yes, so what is there? When we subtract 1 from 6, we got 5, yes, minus 2 by 8. Again, 5, 2 is subtracted from 5, then we will get what? 3 by 8. Yes, so don't be confused here. Yes, we can subtract this type of like fractions in this way. Yes, here we have the numerator 6, 1, 2. Yes, so we should subtract them with each other. That means 6 minus 1 minus 2. Yes, and by, that means upon, for the denominator, we should write one denominator from them. Yes, so we should write here 8. Then after, when 1 is subtracted from 6, then we will got 5. Then 5 minus 2 by 8. That means when 2 is subtracted from 5, then we will got 3. And the answer is 3 by 8. Yes, denominator are same. Yes. In the same way, suppose sometimes we may have the questions. Yes. Question number 3, like, yes. Suppose we have 4 quotient 1 by 2, yes, plus minus 3 quotient, yes, 1 by 2. So students, listen here. Yes, here also we have given two fractions. Yes, but they are in the mixed number or mixed fractions or in the form of mixed number. Yes, so that what we should first find their improper fractions. Yes, before solving or before subtracting. Yes, so as we know what formula we use to find the mixed number. To find the improper fraction from the mixed number is, so we use here is, I hope you remember that is, we use is quotient into divisor plus remainder by divisor is. So here, as you know, is the first one, that means we have given fractions is 4 quotient 1 by 2, where is 4 is what quotient. So here, yes, 4, that means quotient, yes, this is quotient, into 2, that means divisor, plus 1, yes, that is remainder, by, what is the divisor? 2, yes, we should write the divisor here, yes, then after, yes, we should give the minus sign, then after what, again, we have given another mixed number, that is what? The quotient is 3 in the second, and the divisor is again 2 in the same way, remainder is again 1 plus 1, yes, by divisor, which is 2. Yes, so it is, don't be confused here. We use the rule of quotient improper fraction is equal to quotient into divisor S plus remainder S by divisor S. So don't be confused here. S, where divisor means S quotient means this is, this 4 is quotient, yes, this 1 is remainder, this 2 is divided. In the same way, this 3 is what? Quotient, yes, this 3 is quotient. In the same way, yes, this 1 is remainder, this 2 is divisor. In the both fractions, we first of all we need to find which one is quotient, divisor and remainder. Then after we can use the, them in the formulas to find the improper fraction. Yes. So here, yes, we have 4 into 2 is equal to 8 plus 1 by 2 minus 3 into 6 plus 1 by 2. Yes. Then after here is 8 plus 1 is equal to 9 by 2 minus 6 plus 1 is equal to 7 by 2. Yes. Now we got the simple fraction. Yes. That means improper fraction. Yes. And then after we should identify the fractions are improper, like fraction. Okay. Or unlike fractions. Yes. So we can find this easily that what they are as yes, like fractions. So if they are like fraction, then we can use the formula subtraction of like fraction is equal to difference of numerator by denominator. Yes. So students, don't be confused here. Use the same rule. Yes. We have the numerator is 9 and 7. So we should subtract them. Yes. With each other, 9 minus 7 by denominator are same. So we should write 2 here. Then 9 minus 7 is equal to 2 by 2. Yes. Students, yes. We can leave the answer here also, and if they are the factor or multiple of each other, then we can cut it. Yes. So here 1, 2, 1, 2, then we got 1. Yes. So our answer is what? 1. Yes. So here, don't be confused. Yes. You have to solve the questions like this. Okay. Let's go for the other questions. Yes. That means the verbal problem, that means word problem or relating subtraction of the fraction. Yes, I hope you are understanding about it. Yes, if you have any confusions in mixed numbers of subtraction, so you have to first, okay, find their quotient, divisor and remainder. Then you have to, yes, replace them by using formulas, yes, to find the improper fractions. Yes, that means you have to first, yes, first of all, you have to find the improper fraction from them. Then when you got, yes, the improper fraction, then only you can use the method of subtraction. Yes, I hope you are understanding about it. Yes. So let's go for the questions. Yes. Here we have the four number example. Yes, relating word problem of subtraction. Yes. Suppose you have the, sometimes you have given, yes, example 4, questions like this. Sunaina cuts, yes, a pizza, okay, right here, a pizza into 8 equal pieces. Yes, Sunaina cuts a pizza into 8 equal pieces. Yes, she gives 3 pieces to her brother or anyone, to Suraj. Okay, so here what fraction, your question is what fraction, yes, what fraction of the whole pizza, of the whole, yes, what fraction of the whole pizza is is left with her. Yes, students, look here. We have questions. Yes, Sunaina cuts a pizza. Yes, as you know about pizza. Yes, it is in food. Yes, pizza into 8 equal pieces. Yes, that means suppose this is a pizza. Yes, suppose this is a pizza and Sunaina cut it. Yes, Sunaina cuts it into 8 equal parts. Suppose Sunaina cuts it like this, yes, to make it 8 equal parts. Look here, yes. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yes, how many pieces? Yes, 8 pieces. Yes, in the same way, Sunaina cuts also this pizza into 8 equal pieces. Yes, and these both are all are equal. Yes, and she gives, yes, what? She gives 3 pieces. How many pieces? 3 pieces to students. So suppose we have to color, or that means we take out 3 pieces from them. Yes, so here, for that we can color them. Yes, yes. So after giving these 3 parts, yes, we can find what fraction of the whole pizza is left with her. Yes, then after how many pieces are left, so we can count here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes, we can find that 5 pieces are left, but we should write it in fraction form. Yes, so by drawing figure we can, yes, concept it easily, and then we can solve it like this. Here here is total piece. Total pieces S is equal to, total pieces equal to how many pieces are there? S, total pieces equal to 8 pieces. And in the same way, given to what? Given to Suraj. S. So given to Suraj is equal to 3 pieces. Yes, 3 pieces. Yes, so students, here, and as we know that if the fractions, or if there are given total number of parts, yes, and taken part or eaten part is given there, so how we write, or if there is shaded part are given, so how we write the fraction of shaded part, taken part or eaten part? As you know, we have discussed about it in our previous classes. That's why here we can write the fraction of this part easily. That means how many parts are colored here? 3 parts. So we can write 3 as numerator and whole part as a denominator. So that means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8 as denominator. Yes. So don't be confused here. So here, first upon, we should write the fraction of total part. Yes, so here, therefore, fraction of total part is equal to, so don't be confused here to write the fraction of total part. So yes, we can count all the parts all together. Yes, or write the fractions of the same number, by the same number, it means by the same denominator and the numerator. So here we have 8 as the total part, so we can make the fraction 8 by 8. Yes. And in the same way, yes, and fraction of Suraj is equal to, yes, what part is given there? 3, and total part is 8. So here we can write 3 by 8, yes, because Suraj has taken, yes, 3 part, and there are total part is 8. So we can write the fraction like this. In the same way, yes, to find the remaining parts, or to find the fraction of left pieces of pizza, we can write here, yes, so, yes, fraction, yes, fraction of left pieces is equal to what? We should subtract the taken part. That means what? There are 3 parts taken or given to Suraj, and we have left 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 part. That means what? We subtracted is 3 from 8. Then we will got is 5. In the same way here, also we should apply the same method. That means what? 8 minus 8 by 8 minus is 3 by 8. So here we should apply the apply method is of the to find the subtraction or difference of the like fractions. So students, as you know, yes, to find the like difference of like fractions, as you know, we should apply yes the formula. That means difference of numerator by denominators. Yes, and we can find here, yes, we have the numerator 8 and 3 and denominator are 8 and 8. Yes, so that don't be confused here, we should use the same formula here also. Yes, so here is equal to what are the numerator? We should subtract the numerator with each other. So here we have numerator 8 minus 3 by 8. Yes, because numerator are same. So that is we can got here 8 minus 3 is equal to 5 and by 8. Yes, so here this is yes the our answer yes for the questions that we got. That means 5 by 8 fractions yes that is left with her. Yes, of pizza. In this way we can find yes this type of problems of fractions. So after this much, yes, now this is the time for homework assignment. I hope all of you are understanding about the fractions, addition and subtraction. Yes, I hope you are understanding. So students, for further practice you should yes use your book. Yes, so here we have question like this. Yes, we have questions like this. Subtract the following question SW. Yes, subtract the following. Yes, subtract the following. We have question A. Yes, 7 by 2 minus 2 by 8. Yes, question number B is 7 by 9 minus 3 by 9 minus 1 by 9. Yes, question number C, that is yes 3 2 by 5 minus is 2 1 by 5. Yes, and question number D yes is from fraction word problem. So you have to write here Maya is 8. Yes, Maya 8, 4/7. Yes, Maya 8, 4/7 parts of a pizza. Yes, what fraction of the whole pizza was left? What fraction of the whole pizza was left. So students, here we have four questions under subtraction of fractions. Well, first is 7 by 8 minus 2 by 8. So B is 7 by 9 minus 3 by 9 minus 1 by 9. C is 3 question 2 by 5 minus 2 question 1 by 5. The same way question number D, Maya ate 4/7 parts of a pizza. Is what fraction of the whole pizza was left? So here don't be confused here, 4/7 means 4 by 7 part. Yes, and you have to suppose one part as a whole part. Yes, so that means 1 by 1 you can suppose 1 by 1 part as a whole. Yes, or yes, you can divide them 7th, it means there are 7 parts all together. That means whole part are there, that means total part of the pizza are there 7. so that you can suppose 7 by 7 minus 4 by 7 and then you can solve it. Yes, I hope you can do this all. Yes, after this much, this is that this is the time to leave the class 4. Yes, we will be here after this short break. Yes, so keep listening our radio school program. Yes, we'll be here right back.
रेडियो मधेशमसला 106.4 मेगाहर्ज में अब समय है व्यापारिक विश्राम के। तब तक अपने भी हाथ साबुन पानी से मल मल के धो के आओ। कोरोना वायरस से अपने भी बचो आ दूसरों के बचाओ।
के रामपुर वाली छे, रुक रुक ओतै रुक, के तू भीतर कहाँ आबि रहल छी भोरे भोरे?
मालिक ओही के काज कर लेल त आयल छी, लेट्रिन सफा कर लेल छोटका मालिक बजौने छलथि।
हाँ गे, बुझे छी हम तोर बात, लेकिन तू डोम भोरे भोरे हमर घर की आयल? दोपहर में आबऽ चाही ने?
मालिक हम अखन फुर्सत में छली, तै सोच ली जे अहाँ के काज कर लै छी।
हाँ गे रामपुर वाली, भोरे भोरे डोम के मुँह देखब तो हमर दिन कोना निक हैत, बुझे पड़े छे ने? डोम दुसाद के मुँह देखब तो आय के दिन हमर खराब होत ने?
आदमी आदमी के मुँह देखला से ककरो घर में काज केला से घर आदे नहीं छुआइत अछि। तई सबके सम्मान करू, छुआछूत के जड़ से हटाऊ आ समाज में सबके सम्मान करू।
नेपाल सरकार, संचार तथा सूचना प्रविधि मंत्रालय।
कोविड-19 अर्थात कोरोना वायरस रोग के मुख्य लक्षण सब
110.4 डिग्री फारेनहाइट से बेसी बुखार आवे के, खोखी लागे के, सांस फेरे में दिक्कत होए के,
अपांगता भेल व्यक्ति सब के लेल कोरोना वायरस के संक्रमण से बचे के उपाय सब।
बुखार आवे के, खोखी लागे के, चाहे सांस फेरे में दिक्कत भेल व्यक्ति सब से सहायक सामग्री सब दूर राखू। ओइसन व्यक्ति के संपर्क में अयला पर प्रयोग करे से पहले अल्कोहल युक्त सैनिटाइजर के प्रयोग करके कीटाणु रहित करू। सहायक सामग्री के हाथ से पकड़ के राखे वाला जगह सब में जैसे व्हील चेयर के पुश रिंग, पुश हैंडल आ ब्रेक, बैसाखी छड़ी पकड़े वाला जगह, चश्मा आ श्रवण यंत्र बारंबार साफ करू। खोखला पर आ हाथे कैला पर नाक आ मुँह केहुनी चाहे टिश्यू पेपर से तोपू। आ प्रयोग कैले टिश्यू पेपर के झाकना भेल फोहर फेंके वाला बर्तन चाहे डस्टबिन में फेंकू। रेख देख करे वाला व्यक्ति सेवा देला पर जैसे सुतावे के, उठावे के, शौचालय ले जाए के, खियावे के, साफ कर देवे के जैसन काम सब करे से पहले आ कैला के बाद अपन हाथ सब के साबुन पानी से धो। सर सफाई के लेल महत्वपूर्ण सामग्री सब जैसे साबुन, सैनिटाइजर, टिश्यू पेपर आ झाकना भेल फोहर फेंके वाला बर्तन चाहे डस्टबिन अपन जोरे राखू। स्वास्थ्य संबंधी कारण से नियमित प्रयोग करे वाला दवाई चाहे उपकरण सब जोगा के रखू। अपने भीड़ भाड़ में न जाऊ आ अपना सहयोगी या परिवार के सदस्य सब के भी भीड़ भाड़ में न जाएला सुझाव दियो। अपना चाहे सहयोगी के बुखार अयला पर, खोखी लगला पर, चाहे सांस फेरे में दिक्कत होइत है तो ऐसन अवस्था में सहयोग न लेके दोनों जना तुरंत नजदीक के तोकल गेल स्वास्थ्य केंद्र में संपर्क करू।
कोरोना वायरस रोग के बारे में थप जानकारी के लेल 11:15 चाहे 11:33 में संपर्क करू।
USAID के सहयोग में राष्ट्रीय स्वास्थ्य शिक्षा सूचना तथा संचार केंद्र, एपिडेमियोलॉजी तथा रोग नियंत्रण महाशाखा, विश्व स्वास्थ्य संगठन, हैंडीकैप इंटरनेशनल, राष्ट्रीय अपांग महासंघ आ प्रेरणा शारीरिक पुनर्स्थापना केंद्र मलंगवा सरलाही द्वारा जनहित में जारी संदेश।
ए रमीला, कितना जल्दी चला तारू, तो समय में ही स्कूल पहुँचे के बाद जल्दी चले के ना पड़ल।
ए सुना ना रमीला, सबीना के दीदी के तो बिया ना होके वाला भइल बा।
ए तो साचो में जा ई कहे
लड़का वाला तो जैसे भी दहेज चाहे कह के कहलन। रमीला के बाबूजी तो देवे ना सकिम कह के कहला बाद उ सब शादीए रोक देलो।
ए कहे के मतलब उ लोग के कानून तो थाए ना रहलो, तो चलो सीधा चलल जाओ प्रहरी के खबर कइल जाबे बात।
ब्याह में लेन देन करे वाला आ दहेज ना देला के कारण से सतावे वाला के 5 वर्ष कैद आ 50,000 जरिवाना हुई आ गैर कानूनी भइल बाल विवाह बहु विवाह आ हाड नाता विवाह स्वतः रद्द हुई।
नेपाल सरकार संचार तथा सूचना प्रविधि मंत्रालय।
रेडियो मधेसमा 106.4
हेलो नमस्ते गुड आफ्टरनून आई वेलकम यू बैक हियर ऑन आवर रेडियो एजुकेशन प्रोग्राम। यस आई एम हियर विथ क्लास 5 मैथ एंड यस इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लासेज एंड वी आर डिस्कसिंग ऑन अलजेब्रा यस आवर एडिशन एंड सब्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ पॉलीनोमियल एक्सप्रेशंस यस एंड जस्ट वी वाज डिस्कसिंग ऑन द मेथड और सम टॉप टिप्स यस ऑफ दिस एडिशन एंड सब्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ यस algebraic express polynomial expressions. So here again we will discuss on them, yes, today also. So we have here addition and subtraction, yes, of polynomial expressions. So students, as you know all about the polynomial expression, that is the expressions having two or more than two terms, yes, they are known as polynomial expressions. Yes, so for that we have given some tips for that. Yes, we have given here in the first tip, that is, yes, arrange the like terms in the same column. Yes, students, so here suppose we have given some algebraic polynomial expressions, yes, that means the expression which is made up of, yes, two or more than two terms, yes, and if they are given, so we should arrange them in their respective, yes, column, that means with their like terms, yes, that means then for example we can submit here, and we was also discussed, yes, in our previous classes, that is, yes, so first upon, yes, we should, yes, discuss on the addition of polynomial expressions first. So for this also we should arrange the like terms in the same column, yes, then for the example of this we can give the example like this, yes, suppose we may have given the expressions, yes, sometimes like this, yes, here x plus 2, yes, and, yes, x plus 2 and x plus 3, yes, we should add x plus 2 and x plus 3 we have given here. And students, first of all we should find the like terms, yes, from these two expressions, yes, or how many expressions are given over there, yes, we should first find only the like term with each other, and we should write them in one column. So here we can find out what there we have x in first and second also, and they have the same basis also, yes. So students, as you know about the like terms, yes, here in polynomial expressions, yes, in like term, that means what, the terms having the same base and same power is known as like terms. So here in the first expression we have given x plus 2 and in second x plus 3, where, yes, x in the both fraction or terms we can find here x as a base. In the same way there are no any base, so that what we can suppose they have bases 1, so that what they have one base one and the same base and same power, that means one and one, so that what they are like terms, so that we can is arrange them in one column, that is what x is plus 2 is, and in the same way 2 and 3 are also like because they are constant terms, yes, and because of constant term we should write they are also like term, yes, so that what we should arrange them in the same column, yes, or respective column, and that is what x plus 2 here, then we should again write this x in the column of x and plus at the same place of plus, then after 3, yes, then we can add them respectively here, 2 plus 5, 2 plus 3 is 5, there is plus sign plus x plus x, 2x, yes, so we can find them like this, yes, a variation of, yes, polynomial expression by arranging them, yes, in the like term in the same column, yes. We have the first point that need to remember before adding and subtracting of the polynomial expressions, but we are here doing sub addition, so here look only for addition. Yes, sometimes we may have given questions like this, yes, add, yes, add x plus 2y plus s 2 and s and 2x plus 3y plus 1. So students, here also first of all we need to identify the like terms, so here we can find x and 2x are like term, yes, because both have the same base x and both have the same power 1, yes, the same way here y and y, that means 2y and 3y are the like term because they both have the same base y and power 1, the same way 2 and 1 because they are the constant term, yes. Then after we can add them, yes, by rearranging them in the same column, that means what we should write first like this here, yes, here x plus 2y plus 2, yes, by that means the second column, that means 2x, yes, plus 3y plus 1, yes, we can see here, we can find here, that means we have written the same like terms in the respective column, that means same column, that means x, s 2x, 2y, 3y, 2 and 1. Then again after this we should start to add them, so 2 plus 1 is 3, then we should give the plus sign, 2 plus 3 is s 5y, s, then after plus s x plus 2x, 3x. Yes, so students, this is the answer, yes, of the question x plus 2y plus 2 and 2x plus 3y plus 1. Yes, in this way we can find the or we can add them. Yes, then after, yes, then after we should arrange for the second tips, that is after arrangements of like terms, yes, after arrangement of like terms, yes, coefficient should be added, yes, coefficient should be added. So students, here, yes, after arrangement of the, yes, in the first example or second example we can find that, yes, after arrangement of like terms, yes, coefficient should be added, yes, so here we have the coefficient, yes, 1, here 1, that means after arrangement we should add 1, 1, 2, that means 2x. In the same way here also there is no any coefficient, that means 1, 1, 2, 3x, then after there is a coefficient of y, 2, 2 plus 3 is yes, 5y, then after 3 and 1 is equal to 3, so 2 and 1 is equal to 3. In this way Yes, after ironment, we should apply this rule. Yes, we should eat the separately or subtract separately. Yes, then after, if the for the sign rule, yes, for addition. Yes, students, so here, in the case of addition, yes, in the case of addition, yes, the signs, yes, the sign in the case of addition, the sign should not or cannot be changed. Yes, cannot change. Yes, in the case of addition, the sign cannot change. That means what? Yes, if there is minus sign, it remains minus. Yes, if there is plus signs, so it remains plus only. Yes, they can't not changes, not changes in sign. Yes, in addition. Yes, that means what? Suppose take other example of this. Yes, if there is given, yes, 2x minus 3, yes, and x plus, yes, 1. In this case, we should use the plus sign, that means to add them. And if they have the plus sign, yes, so the sign won't be changed. And here we can subtract them with each other. That means what? There the sign of plus is greater, minus is greater than the plus sign. So that what? This one is subtracted from 3, then after we will get here what? 2, and the sign which is the greater number, yes, that sign being written here, that means what? The 3 has the sign minus, which is greater, so that what? We should write here the greater sign, that is, which is minus here. Then after, we should add this, that means 2x plus x, that is, yes, 3x. In this way, we can also add, yes, on the case of signing, yes. If the sign is given minus, yes, then after, yes, for the subtraction, let's take example for the subtraction. So students, here for the subtraction, yes, for the subtraction, this one. Okay, again we should arrange the like term in the same column, then after arrangement, yes, coefficient should be added, yes, sorry, subtracted, okay, so be subtracted, yes. In the same way, yes, in this case, yes, minus changed into plus, and yes, plus sign changed into minus sign, yes. So here we have also three tips for the subtraction of polynomial expressions. That is, arrange the like terms in the same column first, yes. Then after arrangement, yes, coefficient should be added, subtracted. Then after what? In this case, yes, the signs are also changing. So that's what? Minus sign change into plus sign, and then plus sign change into, yes, minus sign. Yes, so here we can let example. Yes, our example may be like this. Suppose we have given subtract from subtract x plus 2 from as 3x plus 4. So students, here be careful, here listen carefully, okay, give your concentration here. Yes, here we have question subtract x plus 2 from 3x plus 4, yes, and so that here we should arrange them on the like terms in the same column, then after arrangement of the like term, then after we should subtract the coefficient, yes, and the constant letter. Then after, if there are different signs, so we should change them, change the sign first. So there we can do like this here, yes, here the number which is given before from, so that should be subtracting from the number which is given after the from. So 3x plus 4 is given after from, so that what we should is subtract x plus 2 from 3x plus 4, and for that we should write first 3x plus 4. So here 3x plus 4, yes, and x plus 2, yes, we should we have written here the same terms or the like terms in the same column, that is 3x and x, 4 and 2, yes. Then after we have here in the sign, that means minus change into plus and plus change into what, minus. So we can find here, yes, if there is no any sign and only the lower the terms of having lower and the term which is written at the lower part, yes, and which is subtracting, okay, only changing the sign or only change the sign, their signs. So here x plus 2 is subtracting from 3x plus 4, so that's what the sign of x plus 2 is only changing here, yes. So here, yes, if there is no sign in front of x, that is what, there is plus sign, so that what, this plus sign is changing into minus sign, yes, and there is also in front of 2 there is plus sign, yes, that sign is also changing into minus sign, yes. Then after what, this plus is, yes, gone from there, that is what, there is minus, so that what, 4 minus 2 is equal to what, 2, and we can find here the sign of plus is greater than the minus sign, so we should write here plus sign, okay, don't be confused here. And then 3x minus 2 x is equal to what, 2x, yes, and there is also plus sign is greater, that means we have written here plus, there is no sign, it means plus sign, yes. In the same way, suppose sometimes we may have questions like this, yes. Here, subtract 2x minus is 3y plus 1 from is from 4x plus is 2y minus 3, yes. There we have questions, yes, subtract 2x minus 3y plus 1 from, yes, 4x plus 2y minus 3, yes. In this case also, yes, we should write the number which is given after the from, that should be written at first, and the number which is given before the before from, that should be subtracting from the number which is given after from. So here 4x plus 2y minus 3, yes, then after 2x minus 3y plus 1, yes, first upon we should arrange them to their respective column, then after arrangement we should subtract their coefficient and we should change the sign, yes, again. So here there is no any sign, it means what, there is plus sign, yes, that means we should change the plus sign that into minus. Then there is plus minus sign, so we should change this sign into plus. And there is plus sign, so we should change this sign into minus. Yes. Then after this sign, yes, has been gone here from here. Then after what? Minus and minus. Yes. If both that means if the number has the same sign, yes, so sign should be written which is given over there, and the number should be added. Yes, so there is given minus minus, so we should write the same sign, and but we should add 3 plus 1. That is what 3 plus 1 is equal to 4. So minus 4, then after there is plus and plus sign, so that plus 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 sign, and we should add them, okay, with each other. That means 2 plus 3 is equal to 5y. Then after what, 4 minus 2x is equal to 2x. Yes, in this way we can subtract them with each other. Yes, if the terms are given or if the expressions are given, yes, in this way, okay. Okay, in this way for today the time is over, and this is the time to assign your homework. Yes, so I hope you are understanding about the addition and subtraction of the polynomial expression. Yes, I hope that. Yes, and write the homework. Yes, your homework is like this. Yes, here, add and subtract, add the, yes, homework, question number 1, find the sums. Here, question number A, yes, question number A, 3p plus 9 and yes, 2p plus 5, yes, question number B, yes, 3a, yes, plus 2b plus 5 and yes, 2a plus 4b plus 4b plus 2, yes, in the same way, question number 2, that is, yes, find the difference, find the difference, says yes, and the questions are like this, yes, 3y plus 4 from, yes, 3y plus 4 from 4y plus 7, 4y plus 7, question number B, yes, p plus q plus r from, yes, 2p plus 3q, yes, minus 2r. Yes, students, you have this much questions for practice, and you can use your book for further practice. Yes, in this way, I hope you are understanding about these all. Yes, and I hope you can solve this. I repeat the questions once again here. Find the sum. In question number A, there is, yes, 3p plus 9 and 2p plus 5. In second B number question, 3a plus 2b plus 5 and 2a plus 4b plus 2. You have to find their sum. That means you have to add them. Yes. Then after, in question number 2, there is given what? Yes. Find the differences. That means you have to find subtract them with each other. Yes, from each other. That means in the first question there is given 3y plus 4 from 4y plus 7. Yes, in the same way, question number B, p plus q plus r, yes, from 2p plus 3q minus 2r. Yes, I hope you will do this all. Yes, and you got this all. Yes, and after this much, this is the time to leave the class. Yes, from here, yes, to put in the today's radio educational program here, yes, which is sponsored by Nepal Police School. Yes, in the same way, before leaving the class, I would like to thank you all for listening and watching our radio educational program. Yes, in the same way, I would like to thank our technician friend, yes, to support, to help me to run the program, yes, successfully. Yes, by saying this much. Okay, keep listening. Radio Madhes Masala 106.4 MHz. Take care. Bye-bye.